Good evening, everyone. Let's begin today's talk. VIMHANS, a premier institute in the field of mental health and neuroscience, has constantly endeavored to build awareness on various mental health issues and well-being in the community over the last few years. As part of this endeavor, we started a series on positive psychology with the goal at building better insight into individual well-being, contentment, and in the pursuit of happiness and meaning in life. As we continue with the series on positive psychology that began last year in the month of March, we bring you today the topic pro-social behavior in children. It is an important topic because pro-social behavior is a foundation in social interaction with families, peers, and friends. The presenter for today's topic on pro-social behavior in children is Priyanka Talega, licensed practitioner currently working as consultant clinical psychology at VIMHANS. She completed her MPhil in clinical psychology from Behaviours. She has worked before at Lady Harding Medical College in the Department of Pediatrics before joining VIMHANS. She conducts assessments and psychotherapeutic work for children presenting with emotional and behavioral issues as well as parenting concerns. She is also involved in conducting awareness-based talks at VIMHANS and other organizations such as NIPSED. Today she will present on aspects of pro-social behavior and how we can promote the same in children through positive parenting. I welcome you, Priyanka. You can start. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am, for introducing me. Good evening, everyone. So myself, Priyanka, I am a clinical psychologist working currently at VIMHANS. So I have chosen this topic because I think this is quite relevant in today's scenario. In my practice, I've usually seen parents coming with difficult children or having problems like child temper tantrums or not being able to study properly at school or even at home. So while they come to me, they usually come up with negative behaviors of the children, and they usually don't notice the strength of the child. So this is a common scenario. So keeping this thing in mind, I've chosen to talk about this topic that we should also strengthen the positive behaviors in the children along with helping the children in reducing their negative behaviors. So yeah, coming on to the presentation, I welcome you all. So we have seen that we are faced with global challenges like developmental degradation, poverty, social injustice, and discrimination around us. It is important to promote concern for the well-being of others and encourage pro-social behavior. The development of pro-social behaviors does not, however, occur in children, but rather in the context of development in other behavioral and affective spheres. And we have usually seen that human engage in helping each other, and humans provide more assistance to family, friends, and strangers, even when costly. So, and we have also seen people like Mother Teresa, Nelson Mandela, who has actually worked in the field of pro-social behavior. During my presentation, I'm going to talk about according to this outline, like what is it about? I mean, what is pro-social behavior? What all factors motivate pro-social behavior? What predicts pro-social behavior? The role of parenting in promoting pro-social behavior? And specifically, what are the strategies that can promote pro-social behavior in children? Moving on to the definition of pro-social behavior. So Nancy Eisenberg is the pioneer in the field of developmental social psychology, and he has defined pro-social behavior as voluntary actions that are intended to help or benefit another individual or group of individuals. Coming on to the forms of pro-social behavior, it could be in the form of one's sharing behavior, one's helping, or it could be comforting another person, or it could be in form of showing kindness or gratitude. More specifically, if I see one study in 2002, Randall, he has actually given six types of pro-social behavior. So pro-social behavior could be compliant when somebody helps you when it is asked from the other person, or it could be help in a dire situation when there is some emergency, or it could be public when somebody wants to show people that I usually help people around me, or it could be unwanting help where people would not want people to let know that they are helpful towards each other. Coming on to next phenomena which is involved with prosocial behavior. So before I talk about that, usually this kind of the prosocial behavior of any form basically orient towards protection, maintenance or enhancement of well-being of an external object. So it could be a specific person, a group or society or as a whole. So sometimes we have seen that it can be mistakenly or interchangeably used with the another concept of altruism. But if we compare the two, both are different. Prosocial behavior is more of an umbrella term of which altruism is part of. So prosocial behavior has to do with a pattern of activity, while altruism is just a motivation to help somebody. So it's basically a drive. And so prosocial behavior is that behavior which one does consciously, voluntarily, willingly, without any obligation, on his own. Okay. So if we trace the history of prosocial behavior, where did that concept in particular has come from? So we can trace it to the case of Kitty Genovese. It's a very famous case which has actually given us the understanding about the bystander effect. So during 1960, it was noticed that when this lady was died, in fact murdered, in front of her 38 neighbors, nobody actually tried to help her or came forward, even after witnessing the case with their own eyes. And after this,